Hello folks, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's feature is going to be about great project management applications that you can use at home or for remote work. So without further ado folks, let's dive into today's video. So as you can imagine, working from home using a project manager can sometimes be tricky. Some of them don't necessarily have great capabilities. So we've handpicked 9 options for you that we think will be successful for using at home. So we've done them by 3 criteria points, that is communication, collaboration, and flexibility. Now, just to be clear, I've selected more all-rounders here because we're going to be doing some more sort of project management breakdowns in terms of specialist tools. But all of these either have good chat abilities or integrate with Slack or Zoom. Now, you can get all of them below and it will be timestamped with any discounts that I find below. Okay, so the first option is a project manager called TaskWorld. Now, TaskWorld has some great channels that allows you to chat in real time with other people in your team. So TaskWorld also has some Gantt chart abilities that allow you and your team to see timelines visually, which is perfect for planning timescales. It also does have some time tracking tools, which will allow your remote employees to track the time they spend on certain projects. Inside of TaskWorld, you can also see performance metrics, allowing you to see how well your team is performing across the day, completed tasks, and also projects that they've progressed on. Now, TaskWorld is priced reasonably at $14.99 per user per month. So number 2, folks, is Hive. Hive, again, is a great all-rounder. It comes with a real-time chat feature. You can communicate with your team members on the left-hand side, either starting channels per department or starting direct messaging too. Now it has this sort of tab-based project management, allowing you to create these tabs on a certain type of view or a certain type of project that you're currently working on. A little like you would get with a browser like Google Chrome. It also has 1,000 integrations, over 1,000 integrations, so it will connect with the likes of Zoom and Slack, which can be quite popular for video conferencing and also communicating with an existing team communication tool like Slack. Now, the price per month is $16.99 per user, which is slightly more than TaskWorld, but again, fairly reasonable, a little bit higher on the price side. So number 3 is Basecamp. And if you haven't heard of Basecamp, I always call it the Patagonia of project managers because of the values it offers as a company. It's really well sort of run by Jason Fried. Now, the features inside of Basecamp that particularly work well in remote work situations is the group chat, allowing you to keep in touch with your colleagues in this very attractive looking group chat. It also has the ability to involve your clients as well, which is something I know a lot of companies like to put in their project management experiences so that the client can sort of get an idea of what progress is being made and what files and accessibility information is available. Now, Basecamp also has these sort of work-life balance notifications, allowing you to set them up so they don't disturb you on certain days. For example, if you didn't work a Friday, but you worked a Sunday, and you worked out of hours from say 9 to 5 or specific hours, say a different time zone because you're working with other people, then it allows you to set those sort of rules and notifications up. It also has the ability to see all of your projects, your schedule and everything else like that in these sort of my views, which is quite good. Now, Basecamp is a little bit more. It's $99 per month, but you get unlimited amount of users if you decide to sign up using that. So number 4 is Monday.com. Monday.com is talked about a lot and it does have some really flexible abilities. And when it comes to collaboration, that's really perfect. You can see and work in real time. Now, some notable experiences, they do have a Google Calendar integration as well as a whole host of integrations for time trackers. I know they also have a lot of form abilities, so you can set up these automations with forms, which do help with very simple things that you can set up in a remote company. They do have a host of templates. Sometimes it can be quite daunting using these super flexible applications, but they actually have like this library of templates which can help you get started. So Monday.com does have dashboards as well, allowing you to see your company's overview or even per department overview of all of the projects you completed, the progress you and your team is making, any activity streams, vital information that might make the difference. But I know a lot of people in companies, at least in offices, actually have these on their screens. But you could apply the same rule at home. You could be able to set this as sort of like your screensaver if you're looking to sort of keep an eye on what's being made and what progress is developing. So something I messed up in the other video was the pricing. The pricing for monday.com is $39 per 5 users. And that works out about $8 per user per month, which is fairly reasonable. And I'll make sure I do when my review, I'll edit that and make sure that is in. Okay, so number 5 is ClickUp, another fantastic all-rounder application. So inside of ClickUp, some special features that a lot of people like to help align your team members that may be remote. You can have OKRs and goal tracking, allowing them to see the goal that they're working towards and to align their tasks towards that goal. And this is a favorite feature of many remote employees. Now, I would say ClickUp also has some really awesome viewing options. You can view anything from Gantt to calendar, to board views and much more, as well as even form views and docs views now. They also have time tracking and also the ability to invite unlimited guests inside of their paid plan. Now their paid plan, again, is pretty reasonable, $9 per month for pretty much unlimited everything per user. Now number 6 is Miro. Miro is more tailored towards designers. It's a collaborative workspace where they can visually plan all of their work. Now this is great for agile and lean teams, but also for designers to work on UX and also uploading their designs for commenting, for modification and improvement. I've done a full review on Miro if you want to check it out, but I was fairly impressed by the application as a great visual collaborative base. It also integrates with Microsoft Teams and Slack as well. Miro also has the mind mapping abilities and is priced at $10 per month. So number 7 is Zenkit. Zenkit has a host of great views. It's sort of like a combination of Airtable with a project manager and allows you to sort of see all of your information in different views, whether that's a Kanban view, a wiki view, which is very popular. You can convert any of your boards into wikis, which it might be helpful for you and your team to find information. And also it has timeline view as well as a range of other filtering and sorting abilities per board. Now Zenkit is priced at $9 per user per month. So number 8 is Asana. Now you may have heard of Asana. It is probably one of the most popular tools out there. And as a remote tool, it's probably one of the better ones, especially if your employees aren't necessarily aware of using project management applications. It's super simple to get started. Now, one thing you can do is invite clients in to certain boards to see progress, also to see conversations and files that you add there. And the Asana applications have great, strong mobile applications, which is handy if you're on the go. Now, the pricing, again, is medium price. It's $13.49 per user per month, but they do have a free plan, which is fairly strong as well. So number 9 and the final one is Wrike. So Wrike has some great all-round abilities. Some of the specific features that I like is the ability to pin useful links. So you and your team can come in, see all of the useful links that they need to see at a glance. You can also comment on images or files or even videos as well, which is perfect for marketers or those who send MP4 files quite a lot. Being able to comment on stuff and not necessarily start a video call every time you do that can be incredibly valuable. They also have a host of reporting abilities so that you can see reports per department, per project, and per person as well. So you can see how each of your team members is progressing, which is particularly useful for example, managers who want to unblock some of their employees. Now, Wrike is priced at $9.80 per user per month, but goes up when you look at more enterprise plans and go past 15 members in your team. So folks, I hope that was useful. I'll put all the links in the description as well as timestamps if you want to go back and check out those applications as well as links. But I really hope this was helpful for you folks. If you have any questions about going remote or looking for tools that would be most suitable for remote employees, I'm looking to do that over this week. So feel free to email me if you have any video ideas, queries, or recommendations that you'd like. Please do email me, francesco@keepproductive.com. But folks, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Do subscribe if you're brand new, and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. Cheerio, guys. Thank you.